You're trying to establish a web presence for your business. You've registered a domain name, you've purchased and set up hosting for your website, and you've pointed your domain name servers to your hosting plan, but you don't have any content on your site yet. First, you need to install a content management system, or CMS, inside of your hosting account. In this video, we'll talk briefly about some content management system options that are available to you, and then get right into installing the WordPress content management system and verifying that it is installed properly so that you can get rolling with content on your site. Let's do this. Welcome back, and thanks for joining me again. This is video 6, how to install WordPress on your HostGator plan. I'm Kevin Stryker with TrueLift Digital Marketing, and this video is part of a video series titled How to Easily Create a Web Presence for Your Business, Even If You Have Zero Technical Skills. If you've been following along in this video series and checking off the tasks required to establish your web presence for your business using the Ultimate Web Presence Checklist, by this point you will have purchased your domain name and your hosting plan and connected the two by pointing your domain name servers from your domain to your hosting account. If you want to check out any of those previous videos, just click the link on your screen right now or in the description area of this video. At this point, someone wanting to go to your site types in your domain name in their browser, hits the enter button, and nothing. That's because you don't have anything on your site yet. You need content, which includes your basic pages like homepage, about us page, contact us page, etc., so your visitors can learn about you and the products or services you offer. And then perhaps blog posts with articles of interest for your visitors, videos, and so on. Before you can get any content on your site though, you need to upload a content management system to your hosting account. There are quite a few to choose from. If you are particularly e-commerce heavy, you may want to install something like Shopify, for example. But if you're like me and you intend on having a blog, combined with the ability to sell things online if you want to or not, or even if you don't want a blog, then something along the lines of WordPress, Drupal, or Joomla would likely be more of what you're looking for. If you subsequently decide to go e-commerce heavy after installing, say, WordPress, when you are choosing your theme, something we'll talk about in video 10 of this video series, look for a theme that integrates with an e-commerce platform like WooCommerce, for example. I think something like 28% of all websites in the world run on WordPress, and according to WordPress.org's website, over 60 million people use it. That's what I run on my sites, and that's what I'm going to show you how to install in this video. Now, not to confuse you, but if you've perhaps heard there are actually two different versions of WordPress, that is true. One is available at WordPress.org, and the other, which has free hosting and even a free domain name with a basic package, is available at WordPress.com. There is a link to a video that I did outlining the differences between them in the description area of this video, if you want to check that out. But as a general comment, I just say that the free hosting WordPress.com option is really more for hobby websites that aren't very concerned with a professional image or flexibility. If you want to run a more professional looking business, then, just my opinion, but WordPress.org is the version of WordPress you will be after, and that's what we'll be installing in this video. WordPress, whether it be .com or .org, is an open source project. What that means is there are hundreds of people all over the world working on it, which, by the way, is more than most commercial platforms. It also means that you're free to use it for anything that you want, within their terms of service, of course, without paying anyone a license fee. So picking up from where we left off in the last video, I'm still logged into my customer portal. It says billing and support on the tab. If you're not logged in, you will have to do that. Refer to your web presence password tracker, if you have that downloaded, to get the URL, login name, or email address for that account, and your password. Like I've said in previous videos, your screen may very well look different, as companies are forever changing the way their sites or user interfaces look. In fact, as I say those words, I do know that HostGator is coming out with a major refresh of their user interface for their customer portal in about a month from the recording of this video. So while your screen will look different, the basic functions will perform the same, you may just find them in a different place. Just scroll down while in the hosting tab, and specifically the dashboard, and there are a few places where you can install WordPress. You can click on this button in the most popular link section, you can launch the quick install, or you can just click the link on Get Started with WordPress Today. They all take you to the same place. I'm going to click on this one. It's going to open a new tab and take you down the page to the Install WordPress for Free section, which is what I want. Just click on Install WordPress. In this first area, they are looking for your domain name with TLD. TLD just refers to top level domain, basically just the extension at the end like .com, .org, etc. Just click the drop down, and I'm going to select TrueLiftDigital.com because that is my main site. Remember, you are logged into your HostGator account, so whatever domain names you have registered will show up here. You may only have one, so there may not be a dropdown. I could install WordPress on either domain I have, or both if I want. I only need or want it on trueliftdigital.com for now. I don't need to or want any subpage. I want to use my root domain, and you likely will too, so just leave the second field blank. I can enter my admin email, and I'm going to use kevin@trueliftdigital.com that I set up in video 4 of this series. For blog title, I'm just going to put trueliftdigital.com for now. Keep in mind that all of this can change later, so don't get too worked up about it, except for admin user. Whatever you put here, you're going to be stuck with. This shows up in places like blog comments, if you have those enabled. So let's say you write a blog post that someone comments on. When you respond to their comment, this admin user title is what shows up there. Since you want to be personable with your website visitors, you may want to avoid simply putting admin here, which I did once, because if Sue, for example, asks a question about something on your website, replying with admin as your username is just too impersonal, in my opinion. So now I just put my first name. You can put whatever you want, but just bear in mind you can't change it. I'll enter my first name and last name, and then just click Install WordPress. They are trying to offer you a premium theme. I'm going to show you in video 10 how to install a theme and show you the one that I use. So I'll just close this pop-up for now. No thanks. Your install is complete. Sweet. If you want, you can scroll down to look at some of the other popular themes. Like I said, I'll show you where you can find a ton of themes to choose which one is right for you in video 10. Okay, so I'm going to open up a new tab, put in my website address, and see what we have so far, if anything. Okay, it doesn't look like anything yet. I'll just try and refresh it. Okay, there you go. A placeholder from Mojo Marketplace acknowledging that my WordPress install was successful. Good stuff. No matter how many sites I install for myself, I'm always excited when I get to this point. So now, if you go back to the screen where we were working on with Quick Install, you will want to click on the View Credentials dropdown. This is very important information. You will want to keep a record of all three bold areas, which I've also highlighted here in green, in your password tracker, or wherever you are storing your website passwords and login info. Your admin area, which by default will be your root domain, /wp-admin, your username, which you just entered in the last section, and here is an auto-generated password that I will change out in the next video. But for now, best to highlight it, copy it, Control-C in PC and Command-C in Mac, as we will be using it in just a moment. I'll just quickly add, for those of you that are watching your first video in this series, you can download your own Web Presence Password Tracker to store all your website passwords and login details by clicking on the link on your screen right now or in the details section below this video or wherever you see it. So let's log into your new WordPress admin dashboard. Open a new tab and enter your domain name, in my case, trueliftdigital.com, followed by /wp-admin. Yours will be your domain name and TLD, then /wp-admin as well, and hit enter. Kevin is my username. I copied the password in my clipboard just a moment ago, so I'll paste it here, Command-V or Control-V, and click Login. I don't need to remember that. I'm going to change the password soon enough anyway. And boom, I'm in. And if you followed along with your site, if you got to this point, you're in too. Right on. You just installed your content management system. So in this video, we just checked off another item on your web presence checklist, installing your CMS, in this case, WordPress. Now that you have your content management system in place, the natural next step is to get some content inside it and onto the web. In the next video, we're going to do a deep dive inside of WordPress and learn all about the basics that you need to know in order to get content published on your website. Hopefully you found this video useful. How'd you do? Did you get your CMS successfully uploaded? It's exciting, isn't it? Tell me about it. I'd love to hear about how you're moving forward in establishing your web presence. No matter how many websites I've set up for myself, I get really excited when I see that CMS uploaded. It means you're getting close to getting your word out there. Also, let me know how I'm doing in these videos. Am I moving too quickly? Too slowly? Not speaking clearly? I know these videos aren't going to be perfect, but I'm trying to create these videos to help you move forward. If I'm falling short in some area and can improve, I'd really appreciate hearing where. I want to try and make these videos as effective as possible, and you would really help me help you by letting me know your thoughts. Please let me know in the comments below. As always, there will be a link to all of the resources I mentioned in this video in the description area of this video. And if you like the video and want to see more from us on this topic, or others, to help your business in the area of digital marketing, why not subscribe to our channel by clicking the link on your screen right now to get notified when we put out new content. Thanks for watching. I hope you're excited about getting your content out onto the web. If you'd like to jump to video 7 right now, just click the link on your screen. I'll be there waiting.